What?
Is it broken? Oh, don't worry. It's just anti-lag. Turbos. What's not to like? Oh yeah, lag. How do you get rid of lag? Anti-lag. If you watched how turbos work, you know that it takes a little while for a car's exhaust gases to spool up the turbo and make that sweet, sweet boost. If you haven't watched it, what I'm about to talk about will make a lot more sense if you do. The bigger the turbo, the more rotational inertia it has, so the longer it takes to spool up, so the greater the lag. One way to reduce lag is with more turbos, but sometimes twin or sequential turbos still got a lot of lag, and a lot isn't good. Especially if you're rally racing or drifting, you need that throttle response right now. Anti-lag, also called a bang-bang system, keeps the turbo constantly spooled up, even when you let off the gas, and it makes awesome firework sound. And it shoots fire from the exhaust. All so you can go faster. It does all of that by igniting extra air and fuel in the exhaust manifold or turbine housing instead of in the cylinders. And as we saw in the turbo video, the exhaust side of the housing, well, that's the hot side. Anti-lag systems rely on that extreme heat to cause gas to spontaneously combust when it gets in there. That extra boom makes more heat. It also increases the pressure in the exhaust manifold, which keeps the turbine wheel spinning, even when the throttle's closed and the exhaust isn't flowing much. So when you go back to the gas pedal, that sweet, sweet boost, well, it's already there waiting for you. Like Ryan Gosling in The Notebook.
It wasn't over. Still isn't over.
This little trick works really well, but as you might expect, it's super rough on all your equipment. That extra heat and all of those explosions put a ton of stress on the exhaust manifold and on the turbo. It's so destructive that World Rally Championship cars get a new turbo after every race. That's not cheap. And that is why stock turbocharged street cars don't come with anti-lag systems. Your warranty would be like, I don't know, 10 miles? But it would be pretty cool. I'm looking at you, OEMs. But if you're determined to blow up gas in your exhaust manifold, well then there's a couple different ways to do it. One, it's called a throttle kick, or throttle bypass anti-lag system, which is where the throttle plate stays slightly open, even when you're off the gas. And that's combined with an ECU tune that delays the ignition timing and adjusts the air-fuel ratio to be a much richer mix. On a typical combustion stroke, the ECU tells the spark plug to fire when the piston is right around top dead center. So you get the most efficient fuel burn and the most power. But with delayed ignition, the spark plug fires when the piston's already on the way down, as late as it possibly can and still keep the engine running. As it begins its exhaust stroke, the extra fuel hasn't fully burned up yet. So the whole exploding mixture gets pushed out into the exhaust manifold. It gets stuck out there, still combusting and exploding right up into the turbo, keeping it spooled up and giving you all those anti-lag benefits. Another type of anti-lag system is called rally style or secondary air injection, which is what you usually see on WRC cars. Instead of cracking the throttle plate open a bit, this method adds extra plumbing before the throttle plate to divert air around the engine when it's off throttle and send it directly to the exhaust manifold. A bypass valve and solenoid precisely control the flow of air while the ECU provides the rich fuel mixture. And when everything arrives at the rendezvous point just before the turbo, bang, bang! The turbo spins and you get anti-lag. Modern rally style systems have a control knob for multiple settings of anti-lag aggressiveness, so drivers can get just the right amount of throttle response depending on the terrain. It can also be switched off completely to stop the explodey wear and tear on the expensive turbo parts. Drag racers, on the other hand, might also have a two-step rev limiter, which isn't actually an anti-lag system, but it does make very similar sounds. A two-step rev limiter, just what it sounds like. It's got two different rev limiters. The first one is usually quite a bit lower than the red line, and you probably know by its common name, launch control. In cars with a lot of power, you don't need or want to rev all the way to the engine's red line to get the fastest launch. The first rev limit is set to minimize wheel spin off the line and give you the optimal traction. The second rev limit is, of course, at the top of your rev range to prevent you from floating a valve or blowing a hole in your block. Two-step rev limiters often get confused with anti-lag systems because they can both be done with delayed ignition timing. Firing the spark plugs later effectively limits the engine's ability to rev, but as we just found out, it also pushes unburned fuels out of the cylinders and into the exhaust manifold, where it goes. If your car happens to have a turbo, yeah, it might spin up a bit, but not like the system's designed for anti-lag. So, two-step and anti-lag are different, but they're both awesome. No lag! Guys, thanks so much. Honestly, we can't do this without you. Make sure you click on this subscribe button. We got new merch coming out. Sign up on our email list at shop.donut.media. Check out this Science Garage episode on turbos, cop cars. Check out this wheelhouse. Follow Donut on Twitter and Instagram at donutmedia. Follow me at bidsbardo. Don't tell my wife an anti-lag system voids the warranty on our Focus.